Let's move on to our third pillar, the actual position for which you're recruiting. Before we get too far into this pillar, let me make one thing absolutely clear. With this pillar, in no way, in no shape or form, under no circumstances at all whatsoever, do you want to simply read the job description for this position. If the intent of your sizzling presentation is to set a hook to attract the candidate first and to screen second, the sizzle is not going to be in the job description. I'll give you an example. They are looking to add a senior sales manager to their team. The successful candidate will be an energetic, effective communicator who is able to accelerate in a sales environment. 7 years of sales experience is required, as well as a bachelor's degree and basic computer skills. The ideal candidate will have a proven track record of developing and maintaining customer relationships, have the ability to hire, build, and lead successful sales teams, and be an energetic self-starter who can multitask and prioritize. Now, let's break that down. Your client is looking for a senior sales manager who can communicate effectively. They need to have at least 7 years of experience, a degree, and computer skills. They need to have a strong track record and be a self-starter. Look at that list. What did I just describe that represents a better opportunity for the candidate? If I only have a certain amount of space in my backpack, I just filled up an entire minute in that backpack of what my client is looking for, not what's in it for the candidate. Now, what do you do with that job order information? You keep it to yourself and you create a strong script that will attract the highest number of candidates possible. Then, once you have them engaged in a conversation, you can ask questions like, how many years of experience do you have? And tell me about your larger clients. What is your technique to develop and maintain those clients? How do you separate yourself from others who are selling to them in the same arena? If the answers to these questions rule this candidate out from consideration with your client, you would rather be the one making that decision than having the candidate take themselves out prematurely. But if you don't have a strong sales presentation in your recruiting call, you will find that you have a much harder time screening first and attracting second. Here's another example. My client has grown to become one of the highest grossing type of firms in America over their 20-year history, and they're currently seeking to grow the next generation of senior sales consultants within their team. A new associate joining this team experiences unparalleled benefits through daily interaction with a tenured team of professionals. The senior partners of this organization boast an average tenure of 15 years. Simply put, they have the most tenured, best practical business experience of any type of firm, and part of their mission is to help everyone achieve their next level by providing the finest and most comprehensive training content in the industry today. How does this impact someone joining their team? On average, new associates joining the firm qualify to be a senior territory manager within 24 months of joining the firm. And as you and I both know, this is a much faster acceleration than exists at most organizations. Notice that nowhere in here have you mentioned what the client is looking for, outside of the fact that they're going to add a senior sales consultant to the team. So imagine that you are, in fact, a high-producing sales consultant who has computer skills and can multitask and can communicate effectively. If you could only pick one of the two opportunities I just described, which would you go for? Again, the purpose of an effective recruiting presentation is to sell first and then screen second, so keep that in mind. So let's go back to our third pillar, the actual position and role that you're filling. Instead of reading the job description, sell the position in a way that highlights the challenges or responsibilities and authority to be enjoyed by the person who accepts the role. Again, resist the temptation to make reference to specific requirements of the position, like the number of years of experience, or the type of degree someone needs, or the listing of the soft skills that are desired. Even if this candidate doesn't qualify for this search, you want to make sure that you keep the conversation going to better understand if they qualify for other searches, either now or in the future. So when we talk about selling the position itself, this can be a little tougher because you have to really know how this role at this specific company presents an opportunity that other roles don't. Typically, we have a tendency to describe the position in terms of the functions that the role performs, which really aren't all that compelling. Think about it. There are tedious elements to every job. If a recruiter called you and said, "I have this great new opportunity, it's to be on the phone for X hours a day and qualify candidates for exciting jobs," that probably wouldn't entice you too much. but there are probably some differentiating elements of the positions that you're working on. Maybe specific challenges or responsibilities that go above and beyond what most people do in this role, or maybe even some enhanced authority. However, this might require you to go back to the drawing board with your client, because most recruiters have a general understanding of what your candidates do all day, but not specific enough to truly compare one position to another. Let's go through an example to better illustrate. They're looking for a project manager, someone who has experience in business development, managing others, and who is really looking to take that next step in their career. If you've got experience with AccuTel software, it's a plus. So that's our first example. We described a couple of the facets of the position, and we mentioned the specific type of software that person needs to have experience with. Let's expand. They're looking for a PM to join their commercial team, but this is a little different than what you'd find at a typical advertising firm. As you know, in most firms, a PM is restricted to generating sales leads and passing them off to the rest of the team. At ABC, you'll be involved with your clients from start to finish, which will help you fine-tune your sales abilities, be exposed to the entire branding process, and surpass most other project managers at your level today. If you have experience with AccuTel, it's a plus. If you aren't familiar with the program, it's one of the most advanced advertising software systems out there and eliminates the tedious paperwork element of our business that slows most other project managers down. So again, you can see that we've highlighted some of the specific responsibilities and challenges that go above and beyond those that are industry standard. Make sure that if you are going to sell the position, you avoid reading the job description and instead dive into the challenges or heightened responsibilities that this person who fills this role will experience. Again, resist the temptation to make reference to specific requirements of the position, like the number of years of experience needed or the type of degree someone needs or anything else that would allow a prospective candidate to rule themselves out of consideration prematurely.